got me crazy for your love.
Hi everyone, this is Lady 2 and 3 from IMVU.com. I'm going to show you just a quick little how to make a room. I'm going to start out by making just a pretty squarish room, super basic. And I'm raising it up to the head of the avatar and then taller. That way we know that she'll be tall enough, the room will be tall enough for her. Then we're going to delete the ceiling part. And in your box, I want you to select everything. Just right-click select all or control A, however you do it, and then right-click reverse faces. This way you have your white on the inside and your blue on the outside, and you can just go ahead and texture from there. Again, I'm just doing something super basic so you can see this. Now, the blue on the outside is what you won't be seeing, and the white on the inside is what you will be seeing. So let me just texture this super quick. And then what you actually want to do right now is you want to make that whole, our whole room a group. Gonna make it a group. Center it if you want. I'm narrating this, so I'm watching it as I go, and I'm like, oh, I could have done this better, but yeah. So right here, you would want to right-click, make group. It just makes things a little simpler. And then you go to mesh out, add furniture pose, or add, it's like add pose and then furniture. And all you have to do is you have to click after it's selected and move it over. And what I'm doing here is after it's selected blue, then I'm tapping the control button and moving one over. Like, don't hold it down, just tap it. You'll see a little plus sign. And you'll notice on mine that, you know, I selected a whole bunch and then tapped control and moved it down. If you have like a lot of rooms or like a lot of nodes you want on, that's the easiest way. Make sure it says on the right of, like next to your mouse, that it says on face. Otherwise, you're going to have things that are all sorts of messed up. Now I'm going through and I'm clicking all of our furniture nodes. And we're going to go to renumber furniture so that we now have, I think it's stance.furniture 01, 02, and you can always do this by hand, but it's so much faster to use the plugins. Thank you, Apocalypse Survivor, because that is what they do. Now, the next thing we're going to do is we're going to add pose group standing. We're going to do the exact same thing. We're going to move it around, we're going to hit control, and then we're going to move the next one, hit control, move the next one. So if you have a lot that you need to do, nope, that was it. And then we have to select all of them again. But instead of renumbering the pose, instead of renumbering the furniture, we're going to go to mesh out, renumber pose groups. And that way we'll have standing one, standing two, standing three. Now, the camera is where it gets tricky. Because you could put this, like, up, save this and put it in, but it won't work right. So we have to go to mesh out and add camera dolly. And it comes up with this really weird thing. Now, what I'm doing right now is I'm trying to find the pose one or stance one. And I want to move this into the center or somewhere where it's easy to find. And then I'm going to want to put my camera over the top of it. You'll see a camera on the left-hand side that's like on the wall. And then over my now standing group, there's like this little dot. And that's, we always want the camera over pose one. And this I actually messed up on. Like I said, I'm recorded my voice after it. This part I actually messed up on, but I go and I show you how I fix it later. What happened was my nodes didn't number right. So now export and then export untextured faces. Or it's like export IMVU file set include untextured faces. Go to your meshes, add your XMF, go to your configure, add your XSF. Don't worry about all the lighting and stuff just yet. I'll have another video on that if you guys want. And then I only have the one texture that I put in. Of course, when you go to yours, you'll have a ton more. If you guys look on my account, I have a pet shop that I made using solely SketchUp. It was like a furry-sized pet shop. It's actually pretty neat. I might link it. But I made that using only SketchUp. Now you'll notice that right here, my standing nodes didn't work. And in just a few minutes, I'll show you how to fix, well, just a minute, I'll show you how to fix that. But my furniture nodes did work. So what I had to go back and do was, it wasn't exporting right, which happens to me sometimes. I'm not sure if I just need to update my SketchUp or what. But my standing nodes didn't work. So this is where I actually went through and I uploaded the new standing nodes and everything. I just went back and I cleaned them out. See, I even put fewer on there just to save time, but I cleaned them out and I redid them. So that's pretty much all there is to it. You'll notice that the camera does not zoom out as far as it might, as if it were in a club, but the camera is a whole other video that I have to figure out. Sorry it's taking me so long to get this up, everyone. My recording thing didn't work out the way it was supposed to. Have a great day! Oh, don't hit double-sided. Thank you for watching!